Hi, welcome to ESP32 tutorial from RoboJax. My name is Ahmed Shamshiri. In this video, we are going to learn how to use this HT16K33 with ESP32 to display integer, float point or decimal points, something like this, negative number, negative decimal value, or clock. You can get the data sheet and other files related to this by clicking at the link below the video in the description, which will take you to robojax.com/learn/Arduino. Let's get started with this. This module works with 5 volts. I've reviewed the data sheet and full explanation of this in separate video. The link is below the video. But for this video, we can just say that this is 5 volts. And the next pin is the ground. This is SDA pin for I2C communication. And the last one is SCL pin for I2C communication. Use this HT16K33 4-digit 7-segment display with Node MCU, WEMAS D1 Mini. Let me explain the wiring. The 3 pins here on the left, this is 5 volts, ground, and then SDA and SCL. The 5 volts have been connected to the pin that have been labeled as 5 volts. And if you have different ESP32, make sure to find the 5 volts. Some of them are labeled as 5. Some of them has 5V with the 5 volts. So I have separate video explaining fully the ESP32 with the pins. You may watch that video. So 5 volts have been connected to 5 volts, and then the second pin, gray, the second wire is connected to the ground here, GND, and here SDA and SCL. SDA have been connected to pin 21, here it says G21, and SCL black is connected to G22. So there is 2 pin between them. This is a 3.2-inch TFT LCD screen based on ESP32. This has built-in Wi-Fi and Bluetooth and can be programmed with Arduino IDE. The product is from Maker Fabs and it has built-in camera. You can play simple games, you can display text, and you can use full features of ESP32. I have an introduction video for this product. The link is below the video in the description. If you want to purchase the product from makerfabs.com, the link is also below this video. Now let me explain the code. The first thing you need to do is install the library. Go to Tool, Manage Libraries. Wait for this screen to complete, this bar graph. Type here HT16K33 and wait for this. And as you can see, HT16K33 by Rob Tillard. And this is the one I've installed it. You will see install button here. Just click and install. It will work with Node MCU, ESP8266, ESP32, and Arduino. So this library works with everything. And this is the address for the library if you want to download it. This line says include the library, and from the class of library, we create an object called segment, and we pass the I2C address. And this is 0x70, that's hex value. By default, this is a value. If you want, you can change it. For example, if you want to use 2 or 3 of these, I have a separate example, the link is below the video. You can change, with, give different address to each module. And start and stop, this is the example for the code. This is an array that is used for example, not needed. This is, we are initializing the serial monitor to display the text. If I click on tools, serial monitor, that number must match. If you go to the bottom, on the right side, select 115,200. Then you will be able to display the text if you want. Segment.begin initializes the 7-segment display. This is setting the I2C address. This is turning the display on. Segment.display on. This is setting the number of digits, set digits. And this is just printing the text. This is running test 6 times. Test is the code that runs every segment, and different numbers will appear. So if you want it to be quick, just make it 1 and it will run 1 time. And display off, we'll turn it off because some of the segments that have been turned on here, we must turn them off. Give it here 1 second. You can make it very quick, 100 milliseconds, and then turn the display on back. And then we turn the colon off initially. Display colon false. If you want to display it, set it to true, T-R-U-E with lowercase. And inside the loop, we set the number of digits to 1, and then so all the digits are turned off, and then when we put 64, it will turn it on for us. So we give it 5 seconds to display 64, and then set the digit to 4, and now we set 64. Now this 64 with this 64, the difference is that we will see 2 digits on the left side when it is displayed because we set it to 4. And this line says digit to 1. Again, we start from minus 74, give it 5 seconds. And here, when you display float, you say display float with a decimal value, and 1 means 1 decimal place. So you do not have more value. If we say 3, then after 5, we will see 2 more. So total 3 decimal place will be displayed, even if you don't have value. And this is for the negative value. Just put negative with a 3 decimal place. This is a 4 digit with 1 decimal place. And then we turn it off, keep it 1 second. And then turn it on, set the digits to 2, and then minus 1. This is displaying display time. This is for the time, 18, the time, time 18 hours and 25 minutes. And then display colon and keep it on for 3 seconds. Then turn off the colon, display colon 1, display colon 0, and then here it says set digits, we set it to 1, and this is a for loop that starts from minus 300, it goes up to 299, every time with a increment of plus 7, starts from minus 300, it goes 7 up until it reaches 299, and every time whatever is this counter will be displayed on the screen, give it 100 milliseconds, so the loop will go. And then this displays the hex value. When you say display hex, you put 0x with a hexadecimal value, it will be displayed for 3 seconds, for example. We go from 15 decremented up to 0, and this is a hexadecimal value. And also, whatever is I from 0 to 15, when you say brightness I, this I can be from 0 to 15, so 0 is turned off. From 1 to 15 or different level of brightness, which I'm going to demonstrate it and give it 500 milliseconds. And here it says that brightness to 15, which is maximum. So this is the full explanation of the code. And here is a demonstration. This is a test of all digits, and then you can display integer like this. Integer with leading zeros, and then integer, negative integer value, a float point, decimal value with multiple decimal places, or negative float, something like this, or negative decimal point, or use it as a clock with colon, negative number or counter. Even display hexadecimal value, change the brightness, you can set the brightness. The code that I will provide you with the library has every possible examples, so you can easily use it with ESP32. I'm now working on writing code to build internet clock for ESP32 and NodeMCU D1 Mini. This will be published. The link is below the video in the description. This tutorial, we're going to learn how we can use the LCD screen of 1602 or LCD 2004 with ESP32 microcontroller, Bluetooth, Wi-Fi unit. In this tutorial, we're going to control 2 DC motors using ESP32 over Wi-Fi with L298N module with RoboJax library. Let's start the motor. This is just controlling one motor. Speed up, change the direction of rotation. And now let's start motor 2. Direction of rotation of motor 2. Direction of rotation of motor 1. And to control it using your mobile device, USB is not connected. We are going to learn. We are going to measure the temperature using this MAX6675 with K-type thermocoupler sensor and ESP32 with Bluetooth touch, and read the temperature in Celsius, in Fahrenheit, or in Kelvin using your mobile device. In this tutorial, we are going to see how we can control the position of a servo motor using ESP32 using Wi-Fi. When I press the start, it goes from 0 to 180 degrees and returns back. And this is type 1, and type 2 is from 180 to 0. When you press it, it goes from 180 to 0 and returns back. If I go type 1, it goes from 90 to 180 degrees. This tutorial, we are going to learn how we can control more than one servo motor using ESP32 microcontroller with Wi-Fi and Bluetooth module. In this case, I've connected 4 servo motors with external power. Now I'm connecting the 5 volts. As you can see, each can be controlled and they're running.